With their attorney walking in the center, Eddie and Shauna Sullivan leave court during a break. They claim their two children, one with special needs, faced bullying at Glenmount Elementary and Hazelwood Elementary between 2008 and 2010. They say their son was beaten, kicked, and even stuck with a fork. They say they complained to school administrators, but nothing was done to stop the bullying and harassment. Baltimore City School Principal Sidney Twiggs and Charlotte Williams still face claims of negligence and gross negligence, but Judge W. Michael Pearson dismissed 9 other counts, including failure to maintain a safe school environment, negligence by the Baltimore City School Board, negligent hiring, retention, and supervision, and a violation of equal protection and due process rights. The judge found no evidence supporting those claims. Out of the presence of the jury, he stated his concerns, saying the plaintiff's case is painted with an extremely broad brush. There was nothing tied down to dates or seasons, and there were contradictory dates. He said the question in this case is about duty. Was it breached, and did it lead to harm?
The failure on the part of these individual schools is a matter of fact. These facts have not been disputed in that sense. The only dispute that we've heard is, well, I don't remember, or I'd never heard about it.
During her testimony, Charlotte Williams said she did not recall the boy being chased and stabbed with a fork. It was not reported to me, she said. Williams added if she had been made aware of the incident, she would have filled out a bullying and harassment report. During closing arguments, Donna King, the attorney for the parents, told jurors the principal is the ultimate person in charge of safety. She said this is a case of inaction.
This is a unique cause of action. It's not a cause of action that has been litigated extensively throughout the country. So we had a lot of counts included that we were aware might be dismissed.
Attorney for the school district, Quentin Herbert, claims there were numerous calls from the schools to the children's parents, mostly about the son's behavior, and that he was not just dumped into a classroom, and that there was care given for his special needs at both schools.